As we have seen previously, we have been able to protect an application with the options that we configure through the presets. To move on to the advanced part, I am going to set it to always protect, and instead of using the individual protections of the application or those of the project, I am going to show how to create an own configuration for this application. In this case, we would click on Save, and if we go to the documentation, we will find all the explanation of how to build the configuration files. If what we want is to create a file directly, we can also do it from Configuration File Playground. With this playground, we will create our own configuration file, and now I am going to show you how to do it. First, we will give it a name. We will leave unchecked the option Inherit Configurations from Project because it would use the presets configuration of the project. Then we can select some presets, which would be equivalent to the existing ones in the Visual Studio extension, but the purpose of this configuration is to create our custom configuration file, so we will select Custom. In this column, you have all the protections available. These may have limitations depending on the Shield Edition you have, but in my case I am using the Enterprise Edition. Finally, we will see the result of our configuration file. For example, we will add the protection of renamer, control flow, advanced constant encryption, and call hiding. Within this custom configuration, we can also customize the protection settings. Let's click on the renamer protection, and we will see that we have different settings. In this example, I will select to rename the public methods, the arguments, and also the enums. We will close the window and look at the playground code, and we will find our custom configuration file. We can download this file, but in this example, we will create it directly in Visual Studio to understand how it works. The file can be called in two different ways, simply shield.config.json, which would apply to all the projects that are found, or we can customize the name between shield and config. In this case, I will create a file just for my project called testing app. I will create a new file and name it shield.testingapp.config.json. I will add it to my project, and inside this file, we will paste the configuration code we got from the playground. Inside it, we will be able to see all the protections that we have selected with the selected options. We save the file. Now we will have to go back to the extension and make sure that the option Find Manual Settings is checked. This way, when we recompile the Shield application, it will use the protections indicated in the configuration file. If we go to the folder that contains it and run it, we will see that it still maintains its full functionality, but if we try to decompile it, we will see that it is protected with the protections indicated in the custom configuration file. In this way, we could manage each one of our applications by means of customized configuration files. It should be noted that the name of the file coincides with the name of my application, but if we rename it to shield.config.json, it would apply to all the applications in the solution. The protections can be easily modified from this file and add new ones, or simply do it from the playground of the documentation. If we want to do it manually, inside the documentation of each protection, we will find the ID of the protection. If, for example, I want to add the invalid metadata protection, I would click on the ID to copy it and add it inside the configuration file. As this protection has no extra settings, its value is null. In the case of having configurations, we will open a new object with each parameter and its respective value. If we now save the configuration file again and recompile our project, we can see that it is now also applying the invalid metadata protection.